2 years after moving in at Jow and Kabong Siri, Joe Sr. was reposted. They had barely left, or the school almost tripled in size. 4 Indonesian teachers were being trained in the U.S., and a $25,000 building was going up on a hectare of land on Jalan Patimura. All that in less than 2 years. It was the Indonesian Department of Education who appointed our first real principal. Ibu Tix Numurti would run the school for 16 years, often under impossible conditions. Tax on foreign books was prohibitive. Work permits for expatriates, impossible.
Oh, we had to start from scratch. We had to gather money from everywhere. And at last we had 8 classrooms and 2 prefab, one for music and the other one for kindergarten.
School-wise, we know that by 1958, there were 180 kids from 28 countries. We know what kind of tuition was charged. We know that Kurt Hayes had beautiful handwriting, and that at one point there was a piano, but nobody who could play. But by 1957, our need for expatriate teachers had become glaring.
When I first started, I didn't know anything about American schools because it was based on American system. And so I went to the ambassador, Mr. Jones, and he said, okay, I will see to it. And in 1958, the first 2 teachers came from the United States.
The first overseas hires at the time were Marion Schultz from Kansas and Gert Hayes from Pennsylvania. Inside, the school was small and the teaching straightforward. Talk and chalk. We know kids had a rock on their desk so the fans wouldn't blow their papers away. And when it rained, the noise was just too deafening to hear anyways. We also know that one of the earlier aides had climbed up to become a teacher. And thanks to I. Anwar, we get a sense of what happened that gloomy day in 1961.
We had a visit by the Minister of Education. It was an unofficial visit. He talked to the students, the Indonesian students, and he said, these students should know their country better. So the next day, all the Indonesian children were no longer allowed to attend this school.
And then suddenly all the Indonesians had to leave. Yeah, I think that was a major upheaval for everyone, because that culture then was removed from us, and the school took on a different tone after that.
Meanwhile, the Cold War was heating up.